Good morning, children. Let's study this topic, which is a long composition, report writing in detail. Now you are all aware that you have to write a report for newspaper or magazine as far as examination is concerned. So today we'll study in detail about report writing. What is a report? It's a written composition. In other words, we can say it is a prepared talk about a particular subject. So what is it? It's a written composition. It is a vivid expression of a personal experience on account of something heard, seen, done, and that is meant to be published or broadcast. The most common example is the news reports that we read in the newspapers. So we come across reports in the newspapers as well as magazines. Now the reports can be in many types. Newspaper report, a report about an event or function at school, a report about an accident or happening that you have witnessed, a report about an inquiry or survey. But what is very important in the examination is a newspaper report and a report about an event or function that you write for the school magazine. So we are going to concentrate only on these two reports. One, newspaper report, and another one, report for school magazine. When you are writing a report, the kind of language that you have to use has to be formal. Be factual and don't add any information on your own. Write in indirect speech and preferably in passive voice. Write in third person form and avoid using pronouns like I witnessed this. So that you should avoid. The kind of language that is used in the newspaper or magazine, that kind of language you should use. Avoid imposing your personal opinions and don't make any conclusions. Answer the questions when, where, why, what, who, and how. So you think about these WH questions and try to answer these questions so that you'll be able to give complete information about some event. Now report writing, here we have to study about marking scheme. The format is given here, but we have to study about the marking scheme. Now remember that heading and reporter's name, that carries 1 mark. Then content carries 4 marks. Expression carries 5 marks. So when you say expression, what does it mean? Grammatical accuracy, whether you have committed any grammatical mistake, whether you have used apt words, appropriate words, whether there are any spelling mistakes. If you have committed mistakes in the case of grammar or spellings, definitely you will be losing the marks. Coherence and relevance of ideas and style. How your ideas are coherent, how they are linked up to each other, how they are relevant. And the style of writing, the way you have presented your answers, that also carries marks. So keep it in mind how to write a report. First of all, there should be heading and reporter's name. Then when you come to the content, you have to write grammatically correct content. You have to make use of appropriate words and you shouldn't commit any spelling mistake. So your presentation of ideas, very, very important in the case of report writing. Since it has got more weightage, you have to concentrate on report writing. A well-written report must possess the following characteristics or features. adherence to the specifications of report brief. So you have to adhere to the whatever you are supposed to write. So you have to stick to those points only. You don't have to beat about the bush. Analysis of relevant information. So what is relevant, what is suitable, you have to analyze that information. Structuring material in a logical and coherent order. There has to be a logical progression of the ideas. You have to develop those ideas logically. Presentation in a consistent manner according to the instructions of the report brief. Making appropriate conclusions that are supported by the evidence and analysis of the report. Now let's go to the format of magazine report. Now in the case of a magazine report, at first of all, they should be heading and then byline. A descriptive title which is expressive of the contents of the report. So your heading, your title has to be descriptive. You can write in 4 or 5 words, but it should make it very clear about what you have written the report. Now name of the person writing the report. It is generally given in the question. Remember, you are not supposed to mention your personal details in your answer. So you avoid writing your own name. If the name is given there in the question itself, you mention that name only. Now opening paragraph. The opening paragraph or the introductory paragraph, it should contain answers for WH questions. What, why, when, where, along with who, was invited as a chief guest. So it should answer WH questions. Account of the event in detail. The proper sequence of events that occurred along with their description. It is a main paragraph and can be split into 2 short paragraphs if required. And at the end, the conclusion. Now this will include the description of how the event has ended or how the event has concluded. It may include quote, excerpts from the chief guest speech or how did the event wind up. So the conclusion should be about that. Now format of a newspaper report. See, in the case of magazine report, it's quite easy. The title, byline and the content. But you have to be very careful when you are writing the newspaper report. There is a headline, a descriptive title, as it is there in the magazine report too. Then there is a byline. Now the name of the person who is writing the report. So in the case of both magazine report and newspaper report, first 2 points, they are the same. Headline, byline. Now next, what is very important in the case of newspaper report is the dateline. You have to mention the place and then you have to write the date. It is generally not mentioned in a magazine report, but it is mentioned in a newspaper report. So you have to remember about place and dateline when you are writing a newspaper report. Now opening paragraph. It includes expansion of the headline. It needs to be short as it is in a general overview of the report. Account of the event in detail. Then next paragraph you have to provide all the details. It is generally written in 2 parts. First, complete account of what happened in its chronological sequence, and second, the witness remarks. Then the last paragraph will be concluding paragraph. This will include the action that has been taken so far or that will be taken, and this is the last paragraph. Now let's compare both magazine report and newspaper report. When you're comparing both, see here in the case of magazine report, there is a heading, there is a title. In the case of newspaper report, there is a headline. So title is there in the case of both. Then the name of the person who is writing that. So byline. Now here in the case of newspaper report, by our staff reporter, by our correspondent. So sometimes they will mention the designation. along with a byline that you may find in the case of a newspaper report. But in the case of a magazine report, you will find only the name. Then here, opening paragraph will be there. But here in the case of newspaper report, dateline is very important. So soon after byline, there will be a dateline. So you have to mention the name of the place and then date. And how the date has to be written, that we'll study later. Then account of the event, then how the event has progressed, then opening paragraph will be there in the case of newspaper report, and here conclusion. So the details, they can be 2-3 paragraphs in the case of magazine reports. You can write more paragraphs also, but remember that first paragraph will be introductory paragraph and last paragraph will be concluding paragraph, and you can go on including the details in the body paragraphs. Now here in the case of newspaper report, account of the event and witness remarks, that you can include in the report, that will be there in the body paragraphs, and last paragraph will be conclusion. Now make sure you use language which is suitable for the audience you are addressing to. Usage of complex vocabulary for addressing children is not advisable. See, in the case of newspaper, you will find the kind of vocabulary that is used is understandable by everybody. It is meant for general public. Make sure you write in paragraphs. Practice previous year question papers. Read as many samples as you can. It will give you an idea as to how they are actually written. When you read the newspapers, definitely you will come know how the news items are written. And that will give you the idea how the news items to be written. You read the magazine, you will find how the reports for the school magazine written. So you can refer school magazine also. And the kind of language that is used, you have to use official language, formal language. You have to write in paragraphs. And after every paragraph, leave one line. Read the question at least twice and highlight the important information. It is very important to understand the question and read between the lines. Albert Einstein once said, if you can't explain it simply, you didn't understand it well enough. So if you understand well, then only you'll be able to explain. A good report should be accurate, free from mistakes and errors. Concise report, brief, not including extra or unnecessary information. Clear, it should be easily understood by everybody. Free from doubt, confusion, no ambiguity. So clarity has to be there. Comprehensive, covering all things, including all things. Well structured, arranged in an organized way. Genuine, real, authentic, true, interesting, not dull or boring, attracting your attention. The report should be like this. Now the format of the report. Now remember here, headline is required, name of the report writer is required, and this is the format of the newspaper report. Place and date of reporting, opening paragraph, account of the event in detail. Remember, headline is there, byline is there, that is name of the report writer, then dateline is there, place and date of reporting. Then body paragraphs there, opening paragraph, that's introductory paragraph, then you can provide all the details, and then it will be concluding paragraph. Now let's go to the newspaper reports. We'll see some examples. Now the question that will appear in the exam will be like this. Last week you attended a heritage awareness program organized by History Club of Modern Public School, Agra. Being a staff reporter, write a report to be published in a national daily. You are Akash or Akansha. So name is written there. And you have to write a report. Now you have to, first of all, you have to find out whether you have to write a report for the newspaper or magazine. And it is quite clear, being a staff reporter, write a report to be published. Now the title. What will be the headline? Heritage Awareness Program by Akash, and you can give the designation also, a staff reporter. If you want, you can put it in a bracket or you can leave it, there is no problem. So remember how the headline is written: Heritage Awareness Program. Now, name of the place: New Delhi, comma. Then you have to write the date: August 20. That is enough. No need of writing 2020. August 20. You see how the date is written in the newspaper. Heritage Awareness Program was organized by History Club of Modern Public School Agra on 9th August from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. in the school premises. The school was well decorated with posters of various historically important monuments. This can be one paragraph or the introductory paragraph. Then in the next paragraph you can write: Mr. K.S. Sahu, Professor of History Department of Delhi University, was the chief guest. Other prominent guests included Mr. Avinash Malwar, Assistant Director, ASI of India, and Mrs. Ratna Rajeshri, Head of Tourism Department of Government of Delhi. Around 2,000 students and parents attended the program. The program began by lighting of inaugural lamp by the chief guest. Here no paragraphs are given, but you should write in 3 or 4 paragraphs. The program began by lighting of inaugural lamp by the chief guest. After that, a skit was presented by students of 11th classes showing importance of our heritage and monuments. The audience enjoyed an engrossing documentary prepared by History Department of the school. The documentary showed a brief detail of 100 monuments from different parts of India. Chief guest gave a very motivating speech on the role of youth in keeping the monuments safe. Mrs. Smriti Pant told about the importance of monuments in encouraging tourism of the concerned place. Principal presented vote of thanks. There was an arrangement for light refreshment also. So this was the newspaper report. Now let's take up the second example and let's find out whether it's a newspaper report or magazine report. So this you have to keep it in mind. Whether you have to write for the magazine or you have to write for the newspaper in the case of report writing. If you write the format of newspaper report for the magazine report, what will happen? Your score will go down. It's a long composition. It has got good weightage, 10 marks. The environment club of your school organized a cleanliness drive to keep the school campus and the locality clean. The students cleaned the classrooms, corridors, playground, etc., and also organized a rally to create awareness among the masses about the importance of cleanliness. Write a report to be published in a local daily about the drive in about 150 to 200 words, describing the efforts made by the students to make it a success. You are Anjan or Ankita of class 12, Ajanta Public School, Delhi. So if you are a boy, write Anjan or Ankita, you write. If you are a girl. Now, Cleanliness Week, that is a headline by Anjan. Now, Chennai, that's the name of the place, 20th May 2024, you can write like that. The Environment Club of Nyker Senior Secondary School, Mount Road, Chennai, launched Cleanliness Week in a unique manner. A comprehensive program had been chalked out weeks before. The campus, classrooms, lawns, the library and the labs were whitewashed, cleaned and dusted. The aim of the Cleanliness Week was to create awareness and understanding among students and masses to maintain personal and the environmental cleanliness. The students also organized a rally to create awareness among the people about the importance of cleanliness. The club organized a number of inter-house competitions, poster competition, aroused the interest of all, including the guests. The participants made colorful posters on health and hygiene. Inter-house cleanliness competition was the main attraction of the day. Vivekananda House was judged. The best house for maintaining the highest standards of cleanliness. The students organize a cleanliness quiz contest and an inter-house essay competition on cleanliness is godliness. A grand gala was organized in the afternoon in the school auditorium. The principal gave away the prizes to the winners. Ramanna was adjudged as Mr. Clean of the school and Vivekananda House the cleanest house. Now we are moving to the school reports. Let's see examples of school reports. Now the kind of question that will appear in the exam. You are the student editor of your school magazine. Write a report for your school magazine about the annual day celebration held in your school last week. Now first of all, the heading, the title, annual day celebration, no need to put it in a bracket, by Umesh, class 12. The annual day of our school was celebrated on 20th Jan 2020 in the Prince Auditorium with great pomp and show. The whole campus was given a new look. The principal and the staff received the chief guest at the gate on his arrival. He was garlanded and introduced to the members of the staff by the principal. A guard of honor was given to the chief guest by the NCC cadets of the school. He was escorted to the hall by the principal. He received a standing ovation by all the students gathered there. The principal read out the annual report highlighting the achievements of the school in academics and sports. The chief guest gave away the prizes to the meritorious students and distinguished sportsmen. Group songs and folk songs presented by the students kept everyone spellbound. He gave a short but inspiring speech urging the students to work hard and rise high in life. The principal thanked the chief guest minister for his visit. The function ended with the singing of the national anthem. Now let's see the second one, and this will be the last one. It's going to be the report for the school magazine. You have prepared a report on a free health checkup held for children in your school, organized by a charitable organization, Health for All, to be read in the morning assembly. Write the report in about 150 words. So you have to attempt this question for 150 to 200 words, since it's for 10 marks. Free health checkup by Anjan, class 12. A free health checkup for slum children was organized in our school last week by Health for All, a charitable organization. Class 11 children served as volunteers. Various duties were assigned to them, like informing and motivating the parents, collecting the children age-wise, and helping the doctors in distributing medicines and health supplements. Many children were found to be suffering from anemia and malnutrition. A large number had liver disorders and worm infestation. Mothers were taught the importance of balanced diet and shown how to manage a fairly balanced diet even in a limited budget. Availability of clean water was one limitation every family suffered from. The role hygiene and cleanliness plays in one's lives was told to them. Deworming tablets were handed out. Some serious cases were even referred for further examination in the nearby health clinic. A list of handicapped children was made so that special aids provided by the organization could be properly handed out. Overall, it was an eye-opening experience for us to see how so many children suffer from ill health. So that is the concluding paragraph. Remember, you have to write this report in paragraphs. Though it is not given here, you should write in paragraphs, opening paragraph, body paragraphs, and last will be concluding paragraph. So remember, in the case of newspaper report, headline, byline, dateline, and then complete. In the case of magazine report, heading, byline, and the content. Thank you. Good day.